What's up, everybody, and welcome to another Angler X video. In this week's video, we're fishing walleye and sauger on pool 7 of the Mississippi River. I go into detail on finding current seams below the lock and dams. I think you're gonna love this week's video. Don't go anywhere. Angler X on the spot.
Look at this! Oh, she put up such a fight!
Good. Talking about right there, folks. Beautiful craft.
Oh, that's a big. That's a big bass.
Oh, stuck him. They're right where he's supposed to be.
Best fish of the day.
Oh my goodness! Crushed.
Another really nice fish.
I'd have a salmon on here.
Got him. Big fish. Oh my gosh. Look at that perch.
Angler X. Honest, informative, real multi-species angler.
All right, we're back in action. There we go.
Beautiful fish.
First keeper walleye of the day.
Yep. And he hit.
What did he get on the blade bait?
Yeah. Love it when they stuff that, boy. I can actually feel that. Very fun.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. 16 and a half. Nope, 16.
A little over 16.
Yep. Beautiful.
Good view.
That's a fish.
As soon as I got down there, dunk. Blade bait.
Should I go for the net?
No. Oh, poor guy right in the forehead.
Sauger.
Beautiful. Beautiful fish.
Yeah.
Gorgeous. Got a headache though.
Well, how good does that sun feel?
Oh my gosh. That's some long overdue vitamin D right there.
It's therapeutic.
Isn't it though?
Gosh. Own. Little guy. Decent sauger. This guy was desperate. If you could keep a dozen fish, that'd be the one.
Died off.
Oh, really?
But the other two-thirds of the lungs, I seen that hit. Nice.
Thumped that one.
Yeah.
No. Oh, it's not that big. Actually, pretty nice. Nice sauger.
Yeah. Mm. I seen your rod. Dong.
Here we go.
Well, do you think we eat?
Oh, yeah.
I think so, okay.
Yeah, we better keep a few. We can save a slot for some bigger ones, but we get 8 fish. So.
Plus Dale's with.
Plus Dale's with. Here we go, guys. Nice sauger. We'll add him to the box.
That fish crushed it. I seen that one too. Don't.
That's a walleye.
Yeah.
It's good to see a little mix. Oh, did he get it? You on?
Yep. Thanks so. Rolled over there, yeah. He bit.
Another walleye.
Looks
like we. Nice fish.
Yep, young fish.
He's a little short.
Mm-hmm.
13 and a half.
There he goes.
Oh, that's a nice fish.
Laser. Oh, keep my keep. Oh, them spines.
I think he's going to be about 14 and 3 quarters.
Oh, I bet.
Breaking my heart.
14.
14. Goodbye, young man. Beautiful fish.
Oh, yeah.
And these are sharp. Fun.
Shown. It feels a little better. I don't need it, but if you want to make sure he gets in the boat, you better net him.
Yes, sir. Yeah, because he could be eatable. There you go.
If he'll make it. Think he wanted to eat that, though?
Oh, he chomped her.
Yep, 14. Come here, buddy. If you want to go back, we're settled down. Here we go. Another nice pool 7 walleye. Show. That's decent. No, he's all right. Yep. Another 14 incher. They're right at that threshold. Mm-hmm. They're thumping it. That's a good sign.
Yeah, good looking fish.
Very nice.
Let's take a break from the action and look at Upper Pool 7 out of Trempealeau, where we're fishing today, to discuss current breaks in high potential areas for locating spring run walleyes. We'll zoom in on the lock and dam here. This lock and dam is very typical of a lock and dam on the Mississippi River, and these theories can be applied to any lock and dam on the Mississippi River. The lock and dams consist of the locks and the gates. The gates consist of two different types of gates, the tainter gates and the roller gates. All the dams have a combination of both. In the locks, we have three different walls. We have the short wall, the medium wall, and the long wall. The flow does not flow through the locks, but it does flow through the gates. The gates can be raised or lowered to control the flow through the dam. When the gates are higher, there is more flow coming through, and when the gates are lower, there is less flow coming through. The main flow current comes through the gates, will wrap around the wall and impede the wall and split. Some of the flow will go downstream, and some will go upstream, creating a back eddy inside the short wall. Where that current impedes the wall is a dead area that can hold fish. Also, the back eddy that's created by the back flow current can also hold fish. Make sure you mind the signs that tell you the upstream limit so that you stay safe while fishing below the dam. Same thing with the medium wall. The main flow current comes off the medium wall, turns, and impedes the long wall. Some of that flow will go upstream, creating a back eddy, and some of that flow will go downstream. Where that current impedes the wall, it creates a dead area of current that can hold fish. Also, the current seam off the end of the wall can also hold fish. There's a nice differential of current and a natural ambush point for fish to eat anything that's flowing beyond this wall. Same thing on the long wall. The main flow current flows off the wall, turns, impedes the shoreline. Some of that flow comes back up into this bay, creates a back eddy. Some of that flow continues on downstream. Where that flow impedes the shoreline, it's going to create a dead area of current that can hold fish. Also, the main current seam off the wall can hold fish as well. You need to size your line and jig in these areas for the right presentation, depending on whether you're vertically jigging or casting out and fishing the jig back to the boat. If we look at the other side of the dam, we also have current breaks over here. Right up by the dam, you have this small inlet. As the main flow current flows downstream, it eventually impedes the shoreline and some of that flow heads back upstream. In that current flowing back upstream is a high potential area for holding fish, as it is less strong current than the main flow of current. Where that less slow current meets that fast current, it creates a current seam up here by the dam. This is also a high potential area for holding spring run walleyes. Going further downstream, we see a couple of runs that flow off the main flow of current. As the main flow flows downstream, a certain amount of that flow has to go down these streams. Some of the flow impedes these points. As that flow comes off the main flow of current, it causes the flow to slow down, and as it runs into these sandbars, it also slows down, creating other areas of slower meandering current that can hold spring run walleyes. Looking further downstream, any sort of current impingement on the shorelines can hold fish, but you want to look for the bigger areas that may cause a current disturbance like this little inlet. You have the main flow current coming down. As it passes this inlet, a certain amount of that flow has to go into this inlet, and it creates a back eddy in here, and a certain amount of that flow flows into the shoreline, slowing down that flow. You get sort of a meandering and rolling of the current in these areas. These are areas that hold fish and create natural ambush points for the fish. And that's where we're fishing in today's video, is in this little inlet right here, catching walleyes and sauger on the Mississippi River. Let's get back to the action.
But yeah, that's why I use the bright line, because I can tell when it hits the bottom just by watching my line.
Right.
You see it's tight, and then all of a sudden it just, or it'll get a little bit of a bow in it when it hits the bottom. Yeah. And I either reel and lift up like this and then watch it. When it hits the bottom, I'll reel back down and lift up and watch it. Or you can just reel like this and just keep it all in one place and watch it. Just reel a little bit and watch it. I call it horizontal jigging, because, you know, you got vertical jigging. Well, you're casting out and you're basically jigging it, but you're bringing it back towards you. Drag's a little loose. It's shown. Nice sauger. Look at how you ate that thing.
Oh, it choked it.
Can't tell me that bait's too big.
What weight do you got for a leadhead?
That's a quarter ounce on there.
Oh, okay. You know, 15 of each, you know, as big as of a river system as this, you know, there you go. I could see their point, you know, if you get a perch get overfished. Isn't that at all?
I think I got him.
Ooh, it's walleye?
Walleye. It's going to be another one of those 14 inchers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, look at my dog.
It's a Kitek Easy Shiner, I think they call it. Quarter ounce VMC jig head. Deadly combination. That guy. Fish.
Yeah.
Little guy. They are not playing with it, they are eating it. Look at the colors on that one.
Oh, that would make a beautiful mount. 3 pounds,
yeah.
17, 18 inches.
Another 3 pounds on him.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, but you know what it is, look how long it's been. I mean, years ago I caught a 17, 18 inch sauger. I mean, I think it was impressive.
You could get like a 5 pound walleye and say, paint it up like a sauger.
Right, big grit to it, you know. Make that the sauger. When it's
not
sauger, I don't care. I'm no pain.
Yes.
You'll do what I ask. Okay. Oh, that was a funny.
Fish. Fish show. Nice sauger. That was a pretty long ooh.
Oohs and ahs from the crowd. Ooh. Ah.
Sure, why not?
Ooh. The long body. Ooh. Look at those big marks on him.
Feels a little bigger. I don't know if he'll make the grade.
Oh, he just swing his ass.
Crunched it pretty good. It'll be close. Oh, 14 and 3 quarter. Oh, nice walleye. We'll get him back. He'll be big enough next year.
Well, there you have it, folks. I hope that helped you understand a little bit more of what I look for in finding walleyes and sauger on the current seams below the lock and dams. I hope you liked this week's video. Thanks for watching.